In the previous video, we learned about neutralization reactions, and we said that once we reach the equivalence point, which I'm going to abbreviate EQPT here, so at the equivalence point, this is when the moles of the strong acid is equal to the moles of the strong base that you're adding. So in this example, moles of hydrochloric acid are equal to moles of sodium hydroxide. Okay. And when you titrate, when you neutralize a strong acid with a strong base, at this point, the pH is always equal to 7.0. And that's because the products of this reaction are water and sodium chloride. So, and sodium chloride is not an acid or a base. It's neutral. It's just, it's an ionic compound that dissolves and does not change the pH. Okay, in this video, we're going to explore this a little bit more and figure out how we can predict the pH of a solution if we do not have complete neutralization of an acid. All right, so let's imagine a situation here where we have, let's say, 500 milliliters of 0.25 molar hydrochloric acid. And to the solution, we add 25 milliliters of 1 molar sodium hydroxide. Okay, so the question is have we neutralized the acid? If not, what's the pH after we've added this amount? Okay, so I think a really good way of approaching this is to, number one, convert each of these to moles. Okay, so we want to figure out moles of hydrochloric acid, and we also want to figure out moles of sodium hydroxide. Okay, so we're going to do this using the volume and the molarity. 500 milliliters is 0.5 liters, so we have 0.5 liters of our hydrochloric acid, and its concentration is 0.25. Let's write this better. 0.25 moles per liter. Okay, and plugging this into your calculator, you're going to see that this gives you 0.125 moles of hydrochloric acid. And I'm going to write this up here. 0.125 moles of hydrochloric acid. All right, let's do the same for sodium hydroxide. I have 0.025 liters, 25 milliliters, and in this case, I have 1 mole per 1 liter, so this gives me 0.025 moles of sodium hydroxide. Okay, so 0.025 moles. So no, in this case, the moles of hydroxide added are not equal to the moles of hydrochloric acid. So this is most definitely not the equivalence point. Okay? So our goal then is to figure out what is the pH of this solution. All right, well, so what we need to do to figure out the pH is to determine how much strong acid we have left over after this reaction occurs. Okay, and I think that a really easy way of thinking about this is as an ice table. But the quirk of this ice table is this is a stoichiometric reaction. So we don't, so it's easiest if you leave things in moles, okay? So only when we're talking about stoichiometric conversions should you leave moles in an ice table. Okay, so we have our ice table here. We figured out our initial amounts. In this case, 0.025 is smaller than 0.125. So I'm going to lose 0.025 moles from both sodium hydroxide and from hydrochloric acid. Right? Sodium hydroxide here is your limiting reactant. And after we've reached the end of this, we have 0.1 mole of hydrochloric acid left over, and we have 0 moles of sodium hydroxide left over. So after this neutralization reaction has occurred, I have 0.1 moles of hydrochloric acid. And as we know, the amount of hydrochloric acid is going to be related to our pH. But you'll recall that the equation for pH relies on the concentration of hydronium, not the moles. So we need to convert 0.1 moles into the concentration. And we're going to do this by figuring out what volume this hydrochloric acid is dissolved in, right? So to figure out the concentration of hydronium, we need to know how many moles we have. We know that. We have 0.1 moles of hydronium. And we know this because hydrochloric acid is a strong acid, so it's completely converted to hydronium. Okay? So that leaves us needing to know the volume. Okay, we know that we started off with 500 milliliters, but we've added 25 milliliters. So our total volume here is 0.5 liters plus the 0.025 liters we've added. So the concentration of hydronium, which is equal to the concentration of hydrochloric acid we have left over, is going to be 0.1 divided by 0.525 liters. This gives me 0.19 molar hydrochloric acid. And now from this, we can calculate our pH. So our pH equals the negative log of that value. And our pH is equal to 0.72. Okay, so we've added a good amount of sodium hydroxide, but we still have a solution that's really acidic. And that's because in this solution, we still have a lot of strong acid. So the pH is still really acidic. Okay, so just as a kind of an overview of this, when you want to do these types of calculations, the first step is to set up an ice table where you're dealing with moles. Figure out how many moles of your acid and your base that you have. Right? So we were given information about the volume and the concentration, so calculate moles. Then figure out your limiting reactant. Set up your ice table to complete it, to figure out how much acid you have left over. And since it's a strong acid, we know that gets completely converted to hydronium. So take those moles divided by the total volume to give you the concentration of hydrochloric acid, which is equal to the concentration of hydronium. And then you can finish up by calculating the pH.